brothers and sisters, we gather for worship in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Today the Church remembers John Coleridge Paterson, Bishop of Melanesia. Born in London in 1827, John Coleridge Paterson came under the influence of George Augustus Selwyn while John was still a scholar at Eton. Paterson went on to be ordained and in 1855, at the age of 28, left Britain to begin his life's work among the islanders of the South Pacific, founding the Melanesian Mission and becoming the first bishop of those islands. His system of evangelization was to train indigenous clergy and so to equip local people to share the gospel in a way that was within their own culture. This bore fruit, and Christianity spread rapidly. Also working in Melanesia were blackbirds, essentially European slave traders, who carried off islanders to work in British and other colonies. When Paterson and his fellow workers landed on the island of Nukapu, they were mistaken for such men, and were brutally put to death by the inhabitants. John Coleridge Paterson gave his life for the gospel on this day in the year 1871. The saints were faithful unto death, and now dwell in the heavenly kingdom forever. As we celebrate their joy, let us bring to the Lord our sins and weaknesses, and ask for his mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, our heavenly Father,
we have sinned against thee and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are heartily sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of thy Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve thee in newness of life, to the glory of thy name. Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. In silence we pray. God of all tribes and peoples and tongues, who called your servant John Coleridge Paterson to witness in life and death to the gospel of Christ amongst the peoples of Melanesia, grant us to hear your call to service and to respond trustfully and joyfully to Jesus Christ our Redeemer, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the second book of Chronicles. After the death of Jehoiada, the officials of Judah came and did obeisance to the king. Then the king listened to them. They abandoned the house of the Lord, the God of their ancestors, and served the sacred poles and the idols. And wrath came upon Judah and Jerusalem for this guilt of theirs. Yet he sent prophets among them to bring them back to the Lord. They testified against them, but they would not listen. Then the Spirit of God took possession of Zechariah, son of the priest Jehoiada. He stood above the people and said to them, "Thus says God, why do you transgress the commandments of the Lord, so that you cannot prosper? Because you have forsaken the Lord, he has also forsaken you." But they conspired against him, and by command of the king, they stoned him to death in the court of the house of the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Praise be to thee.
The response to the psalm is, "You will show me the path of life, O God. You will show me the path of life, O God. All my delight is upon the godly that are in the land, upon those who are noble among the people. O Lord, you are my portion and my cup. It is you who uphold my lot. You will show me the path of life, O Lord. My boundaries enclose a pleasant land. Indeed, I have a goodly heritage. I will bless the Lord who gives me counsel. My heart teaches me night after night. You will show me the path of life, O God. I have set the Lord always before me. Because he is at my right hand, I shall not fall. My heart therefore is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life, O God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. I have called you friends, says the Lord, for all that I have heard from my Father, I have made known to you. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory be to thee.
Jesus began to teach them that the Son of Man must undergo great suffering and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and after 3 days rise again. He said all this quite openly, and Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. But turning and looking at his disciples, he rebuked Peter and said, "Get behind me, Satan, for you are setting your mind not on divine things, but on human things." He called the crowd with his disciples and said to them, "If any wants to become my followers, let them deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For those who want to save their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake and for the sake of the gospel will save it." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to thee, O Christ.
The power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. We remember your servant John Coleridge Patterson this night. We pray for your church throughout the world. We pray that all of the servants of your church may be brave in their proclamation of your gospel. Be with each and every one of us. Help us to have courage to be sent into the situations you are calling us into. Help us to always stand for your message of love. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
Pray for all in the world this night, O Lord, who will put themselves in risky situations because of their faith or because of other principles. Pray for all who will risk their lives in Ukraine this night to defend their country. Pray for all who will go into battle or warfare this night. Lord, to ever strive for peace. Be with those who face torture this night. Give them your courage and your strength, O Lord. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
Pray for ourselves here in Carshalton, for this parish. Pray for our mission to serve the people of this parish. We may be inspired by those who have gone before us to stand for your gospel in this particular place. Help us to connect, understand, and come alongside all of the people within the parish of Carshot. Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer. my sin for. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
So we present ourselves to you this night, O Lord. Prepare our hearts and minds to receive you in the blessed sacrament. So we gather up these and all of our prayers in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, John Coleridge Patterson, and all the saints. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. May the God of peace sanctify you. May he so strengthen your hearts in holiness that you may be blameless before him at the coming of our Lord Jesus with all his saints. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread and wine to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. They will become for us the bread of life and cup of salvation.
Blessed be God forever.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God.
It is meet and right so to do.
Indeed, for it is our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. We rejoice in the glorious splendour of your majesty, for you have given us a share with John Coleridge Patterson in the inheritance of the saints in light. In the darkness of this passing age, they proclaim the glory of your kingdom. Chosen as lights in the world, they surround our steps as we journey on towards the city of eternal light, where they sing the everlasting song of triumph. In communion with angels and archangels, and all who have served you on earth, and worship you now in heaven, we raise our voices to proclaim your glory, forever praising you and saying,
Holy, holy, holy. Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord most high. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again he praised you, gave it to them, and said, Drink this, all of you. This So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence, his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ is died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day, when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people, gather us in your loving arms, and bring us to the Blessed Virgin Mary, John Fairbridge Patterson, and all the saints, to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we pray to him. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And thine is the kingdom, power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, for we all share one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his Supper. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shalt come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed.
Body of Christ. The body of Christ. Let us pray. God our Redeemer, whose church was strengthened by the blood of your martyr John Fenwick Patterson, so bind us in life and death to Christ's sacrifice, that our lives broken and offered with his may carry his death and proclaim his resurrection in the world, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
Amen.
night and always.
Amen. Amen.
The Mass has ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thank you, Jesus.